The 11th episode of Mad Men's fourth season, entitled Chinese Wall, aired on October 3rd, 2010 on AMC. Here's a recap in case you missed it. The episode opens with big drama at Sterling Cooper Draper Pryce with the news that the agency is losing the crucial Lucky Strike account. Ken Cosgrove finds out about Lucky Strike from another adman at a rival company and immediately calls all the partners, who promptly meet and corner Roger about the news. Roger pretends to have no knowledge about the development. Pete is somewhat distracted from the Lucky Strike news because his wife Trudy is in the hospital in the middle of a difficult and prolonged labor while he's at the office trying to manage the crisis. When one of Pete's accounts, Glo Coat, announces they're bolting from SCDP, Don comes down hard on Pete, accusing him of being inattentive and unfocused on his work. Later at the hospital, Pete's met by Ted Chaough of rival firm CGC, who's delivering a Tiffany's rattle for the new baby. He entices Pete to move over to CGC and become a full partner. Pete, who doesn't care for Chow much, gives it some thought and his decision's left unresolved. Peggy is also a bit preoccupied after having another encounter with Abe Drexler. The two are thrown together after a beach party and end up sleeping together. An infatuated Peggy walks around the bleak office with her head in the clouds, even after Stan tries to kiss her, and she finds out that she gave a very important presentation to the latex people with lipstick on her teeth. Don's outlook is more grim, and in desperation, he prods girlfriend Faye to divulge confidential information about which clients are unhappy with other ad firms. Faye is appalled that Don would try to use her like that, but he insists that she should be there for him. Faye storms out of the office. Roger's romantic life also takes a bad turn when he shows up at Joan's doorstep. Earlier that day, he revealed to her that he was concealing the news about Lucky Strike, and now he wants affection and sympathy. Instead, Joan tells him it's over and they can't ever be together anymore. Meanwhile, the partners, who are openly frustrated with Roger's lack of attention to Lucky Strike, elect to scout for new business by attending the funeral of a VP from another ad agency. After the funeral, Megan is waiting in an empty office for Don and asks if she can help him with his work, telling him that she wants to learn the business. She flirts heavily with Don. The two sleep together. Afterward, Don returns home to find an apologetic Faye waiting. She's reconsidered and has set up a meeting with the people at Heinz for Don. Roger goes home to his wife, who surprises him with published copies of his memoirs, Sterling's Gold. For more information on this topic, visit the links below.